Hello everyone, let's move on to the next concept. We were discussing overview of graphics system, where we already discussed about different types of video display devices. So let us see the next concept in this, that is about raster scan systems. We already discussed about this raster scan display in our video display devices, but we'll see how the working will be. So generally in raster scan systems, it consists of more than one processing unit. We know that there will be one central processing unit, but other than that central processing unit, there will be one more processing unit that is called as video controller. So the simple architecture will be like this. There will be a CPU, there will be video controller, and this is system memory. And these three are connected by system bus. And this system bus is again connected to I/O devices and to this video controller. The monitor is connected. Okay, now this video controller, whenever it wants to draw any picture, it has to read the picture intensity values. Now we know, like, we have a frame buffer option, where in frame buffer will be storing the picture intensity values. Now this frame buffer will be stored in the system memory anywhere else can be stored. Now this video controller through the system bus will be accessing that frame buffer, and it will get that picture intensity values, and it will display that into this onto this monitor. Right? We can have another option also, where some part of the system memory will be dedicated for frame memory, for frame buffer, instead of storing somewhere else, we will be dedicating some part of the system memory to store the picture intensity values, which is referred as the frame buffer, and then the video controller will be directly given access to this frame buffer, from where it will get the picture intensity values, and it, by using those intensity values, it will draw the picture onto the screen. Okay, now whenever, this is about the video controller. What is the use of this video controller is, the video controller controls the operation of your picture display. Now whenever you consider the screen, this is your screen. The general procedure will be, for considering the coordinate axis, is the lower left corner is always considered as your origin, and this will be your x axis, and this will be your y axis, and the values of x will be increased in the right direction. This will be 0, 1, 2, 3, like that. The values of the x will be increased in the right direction, where the values of y will be increased from bottom to top. Now, let us consider this is y max. This is the largest value of y, which is called as y max. These are the lines. Y max minus 1, y max minus 2. Like that, we will have the lines up to y equal to 0. Here it is y equal to 0. Now these lines are referred as scan lines. Okay, now whenever you want to draw any picture, the picture value, intensity values, or the picture at a particular position at a particular pixel, what is the intensity value, whether it should be illuminated or not, that information should be stored in the frame buffer. To do that task, generally we need to use two registers. One register is used to store the x value, so let us call that one as register x, and another register is used to store the y value, let us call that one as the register y. And we should have what is the x max value and what is y max value to know the limits of your screen. We should know what is y max and what is x max also. Now initially what happens is whenever you want to draw any picture, the register x value will be 0 and register y value will be always y max. We know whenever in raster scan system, the electron beam will traverse row by row from top to bottom. So that's why we have set the register values of x value. Let us consider this is a pixel position where the register x value should be 0. This is the value should be 0 and the y value should be y max. Now the electron beam when comes here, it will take that intensity value from the frame buffer. If that intensity value, after taking the frame intensity value from the frame buffer, according to that value, it will set the illumination here. If it is off, it will off that one. Once the work is done, the x value should be incremented by 1. Now that means it will move to the next pixel value. The y value should remain as it is. The x value should be increased. Now at this location, what is the pixel intensity value, that should be retrieved from the frame buffer, and depending upon the value it should be set. Now again the x value should be incremented by 1. This should be continued up to the x value reaches x max, because that is the limit of our screen. Now once this x value is reached to x max, the pixel position whatever is there, there will be set according to the intensity values. Once this x value is reaching the x max, we need to go to the next row. To do that, again we need to set the x value to 0 and we need to reduce the y value by 1. That is y max minus 1. So that we need to go to the next pixel position. And whatever the method we have used here, the same method should be followed here, where get the pixel intensity value of this from the frame buffer and set here, set the pixel value, and then increase the x value, get the pixel intensity value, do that work, and again increase the x value and continue here up to when x reaches the x max. If that is over, again set the x value to 0 and y value should be decremented by 1. That is the technique we need to follow. Once all the scan lines are traversed, right, if the x value is 0 and y value is 0, we need to traverse this also. Now we need to halt at a position where x value is equal to x max and y value becomes 0. That means the printing or the painting of that picture is done. Now once this is done, we need to refresh our image. Why? Because it should be continuously displayed. To do that, again what happens is the video controller will shift the control beam to this position. What is that position? The x value is 0 and the y value will be y max, and whatever procedure we have done, that will be continuously repeated to make the picture visible. This is the procedure that is followed in the raster scan system, where row by row the electron beam will be traversed and depending upon that the x and y register values will be set. Right? Now we discussed like there will be a video controller, and that video controller will be accessing the memory from the frame buffer. Or else we have another option also, where we can have a display processor also. So how the architecture will be is, this is the CPU, you can have a display processor, this is the system memory, these three are connected to system bus. display processor, we have a memory, external memory, which is called as display processor memory and a frame memory, to which video controller is connected, and the monitor will be connected to this. Now, what is the use of this display processor is, this display processor digitizes the picture and it stores its intensity values in this display processor, from where the video controller will get this one. Now, what is the extra work will be done by this display processor is, by using this display processor, we can convert the type of the line display. If you want, you can display the dashed line. If you want, you can display a solid line. If you want to display, you can display a thin line. Or you can also set the color also. Let us see your image. If you want to display the image is A. At these positions, you can set the color also, and that can be done by using the display processor. This is the total working of your raster scan display systems. Thank you. Okay, as part of our graphic system, we discussed about video display devices, raster scan systems. Now let us go to the next concept, that is random scan systems. So the simple architecture of random scan system involves, it consists of a CPU, system memory, a display processor, to which the monitor is connected. Now these three are communicated through the system bus. Now, in this type of raster scan system, application program will be given as input to the system memory along with the graphics package. So we should have application program and we should have the graphics package also. Now, this graphics package will convert this application program into a data file, and that data file should be stored in the memory. That can be stored anywhere in this system memory. So this consists of data file. Now here, this display processor takes this data file and according to that it will draw pictures onto the screen. Now we know what is raster scan display. In raster scan display, there is a possibility to draw only straight lines. We can't draw the curved lines. Now how to store the pixel intensity value? So whenever you want to draw a straight line, it requires two endpoints. So the information about the picture, whenever you want to draw in the raster scan system, we need to store the coordinate endpoints only. So those coordinate endpoints will be stored in the system memory, and those coordinate endpoints are referred as x1, y1 and x2, y2. Let us suppose those will be the endpoints. So whenever these two endpoints are stored in the system memory, the display processor will take these two endpoints and it will focus the electron beam in between these two endpoints and it will draw the straight line. Now let us suppose, as an example, if you want to draw a image like this A. Now we should have in the system memory the endpoints for this line. Let us suppose these two endpoints should be stored in the system memory, and the electron beam should draw the straight line between these two endpoints. And afterwards, after the drawing of this line is over, then the display processor will take these two endpoints as input and draw the line between these two, and the electron beam will draw the line between these two endpoints. Once this line is over, then the display processor takes as input the endpoint between these two as endpoints, and the electron beam will draw the line segment between these two endpoints. So there is only provision for drawing a straight line using random scan system. We have to provide the endpoints. Now here the display processor is also called as display processing unit or graphics controller. This is about random scan systems. You can also talk about graphics monitor way. If you are talking about a graphics monitor, we need to draw images for different shapes. Then we need to consider the display of raster scan display only, because there is a provision of drawing the curved lens. Now this graphics monitor can be for general purpose computers with some graphic packages to more sophisticated system where they are only dedicated to graphic applications only. The general computer system, the screen size will be from 12 inches to 26 inches, where if you are considering more sophisticated systems which are only dedicated for graphic applications, then the screen inches starts from 27 inches. And here the color capacity, the selection capacity can be ranges from 16 to 32 to 26,000. Right? Now for 27 inches more sophisticated graphic system, if you are considering, the pixel resolution may change, may ranges from 2046 to 1562 2560 to 2046. The resolution may be between these two. So this is about graphics monitoring system. So this comes under overview of graphics systems. Thank you.